add buttons.
Add bad buttons.
No, there's sad buttons.
I still have to depress the button.
Call names, they'll depress it.
I gotta open another giveaway still.
Ooh.
That helps. But on the set.
Quiet on the set. You're listening to WRFB Radio Free Britannia. Coming to you live from Deltona, Florida. 8 years plus and still running. Who'd have ever thought they'd last this long? Lunch with no other than the dynamic duo themselves, Laz and Jack.
Greetings, everybody. This is Laz.
And this is Jack. Welcome to another glorious Monday here on Lunch with Laz and Jack, where we interpret the Shroud of the Avatar news so you don't have to.
That's right. It's so wonderful that Jack is really excited to be here today, as you can tell.
If I could take the week off, I would.
All you gotta do is say something.
I'm aware of that.
A busy week at work, or just, need some time off?
It is, like, yesterday I was in the Benadryl-induced coma, so I think I slept for, like, 16-18 hours. I was very cat-like yesterday.
Yeah, okay. Well, I guess
you're clawing a lot of things.
Well, like, if I go outside, I can feel like my throat constricting, and I mean, so allergies doing weird shit, and then after that, it's like my right ear's got like some weird ow, and that's where my earbud goes as well.
You just hold tight, because we're going to have some time off coming up next month.
Mm-hmm.
So letting everybody know now, we're going to be off for quite some time next month as I head south once again, and I'll be gone at least a week, if not two. Might be straight through Thanksgiving. Don't just know yet, but we'll keep you apprised and updated when we get closer. But I do know I'm planning on leaving on the 10th, so I know there'll be no show that Friday. And then depending on how long I spend, I guess I'll have to be back in time, because I have to do Thanksgiving here, but
You going to Jamaica, Bahamas?
Yeah.
Fort Myers.
Visiting Dad?
Yes.
Not too far south, then.
Yeah.
It's the Pops visit.
It's 4 hours south, but Yeah, I'm gonna be cleaning out a garage, cleaning out a studio, getting ready to do painting, getting ready to get the house in some spiffy condition in case he decides he wants to move.
Ooh.
Yes. Because
Yeah.
yeah, he's thinking about making the move finally, and got things to do. Plus, he's just got so much clutter still down there from 20 plus years. It just needs to be cleaned out, and got to go give my old man a hand because he can't do all
Hey,
that
when
stuff
you're
himself.
done with that, come over to my house and declutter and
Shit. Your house, you don't even have your house 4 years yet, for crying out loud.
Yeah, how much have
Declutter.
you cluttered?
So, yeah. I don't know if I want to touch half the stuff in your house, let alone.
Yeah, you
I
do. Yeah, you
don't
do.
play with it all, that's right.
Yeah, and you'll play with it all. I mean, it's like just run around like wave things.
There's gonna be some girls to chase things around with. I'll tell you. I'm sure that could be
Depends
arranged.
on
I'm sure that could be
the night,
arranged.
yeah.
All right, anyway. Welcome to today's show, boys and girls. Of course, it is Monday, October 9th, 2023, here inside and outside Trinity Avatar. And of course, as promised, we've got some feedback to get to. And as I thought,
Oh, yes.
feedback got even deeper into treasure maps, because treasure maps are a hot topic right now since they made an appearance on QA.
Yes. And remember, applaud the dev team for releasing it
On
to
the QA,
QA
3 weeks in
like
advance.
well the 3 weeks in advance of release, so it could actually be tested.
Yes.
I mean, this is what they should be doing every single month. So kudos to Devil Cult and Sanyo for getting this shit out there. And which one,
Which one, what?
which message do we want to start with? Rinaldi's?
Starting with feedback, starting from the top.
Okay, from the very top. So
From the
Gwendolyn,
top. Starting
yay,
from the
treasure
top.
maps. Very nice implementation. So far, I have done the initial quest and I've also found the treasures using decrepit treasure maps 1, 2, and 3. For the third one, Bella was in the party when I dug it up and the loot rolled properly. A single mob appeared when I dug up number one. See spoiler below. I don't know why people are like doing spoilers on this. They should be attaching like videos and
Screenshots. Yeah.
screenshots for every single little thing. And because it's like, it's not really a spoiler. You're helping other people test stuff by hiding that information for testing. You're not really helping the rest of the team.
I want some chili cheese dogs.
Yes.
Me too.
So a single mob appeared when he dug up number one, and several mobs spawned at treasure number two. No mobs appeared when they dug up number three, and he assumes that it's because the location spawns to begin with, so we had to clear them before digging up the treasure. But if others were supposed to spawn, maybe they don't if you're in a party. Only once when I tried digging was I in the wrong spot and had to move over and start digging somewhere else. So I think there's a nice size area you are allowed to dig, unlike the Vicland ones where you need to click a very small spot. However, Bella was having trouble digging up the initial quest chest, so there might be an issue there. Maybe if someone else has done that recently, hopefully she'll post her experience here. But I was in a private instance and not in a party when I did the quest, and I didn't have any issues. The single mob at the first treasure I dug up was a blue poison dart frog. Yay, I tamed him and was able to summon him and fight with him. I did expect the blue one to have a higher summon level than the red poison dart we already have, but he does have slightly higher health levels.
Interesting. So if a critter comes up that's tameable, you can tame it instead of killing it. That's an interesting mechanic, to say the least. I like that idea.
Yes.
I think I've got a frog. Do I have a frog in inventory?
Yeah. And Berrigan, not helpful with excited for treasure maps.
Yeah, that's not...
Not helpful. It's feedback. Okay, here we go from Belladonna. The only thing I didn't do was talk to junior treasure hunters, but Selic talked to me and gave me his quest to find a trinket. I found the outhouse and looked around, dug all around the dang thing, and cannot get it to spawn. I've done this both in party mode and open, so not sure what the deal is. I have talked to him a second time, and as far as he knows, I am on the quest still. I still get the marker on the map and the compass that I'm in the spot. So I've messaged that comes up. I am in the right areas. That there's also when mousing over the area says loose ground. I have tried and all on and all around that spot, even logged out of the game totally and back in.
Is it in the screenshots?
Yeah. And that way you can like put X's everywhere that you dug for the debug comments. Rinaldi with nice work. Here are some. After digging, a message pops up that says something like, you hit something, but now you're not alone. And when you kill all the waves of treasure guards, the chest just pops up out of the ground. I would prefer if this mechanic worked like this. After digging the first time, a message pops up. Your shovel hit something unusual. You'll have to dig more, but first you must kill the nearby creatures that guard this area. After you kill all the treasure guards, then another message appears that states, now that nearby creatures are gone, you can continue digging, then go and dig another time, which reveals the chest, and this triggers the timer. After the chest appears, the timer states, time before reset, XXXX. A player less familiar with the game may think that that means that for some reason Soto will reset, such as for a patch, or that the zone will reset. I think it would be more clear to have timer treasure chest resets in blank. Then Devil Cult with, I'm not sure that's in yet. I'll have to ask Sanyo about it. Completely forgot about that part with the outhouse, lol. Oopsies.
Gotta go jump in the outhouse.
Yeah. Gwendolyn with, it is in. I completed the quest successfully, but for some reason it's not working for Bella. She is able to find other chests, though. Yeah, we just went to test it. Sanyo might have found some fix. Should be in the next patch. That was on Wednesday. And spoiler, I got a recipe for a stone balustrade straight from one of the chests, and Bella got a recipe for a corner piece, I think. Excited to have some new recipes. It would be good if they could just be made a bit more squishy, though. There are obvious seams when you put two together. That would be a bug report for something completely different.
Bug.
You're putting two and two together. I could tell by the expression on your face that you're putting two and two together.
Yes.
Did anybody get that?
No.
Maybe.
Guess not.
Then after that,
Belladonna Rose.
All in all, though, having a blast with devious devs. Still not figuring out the bloodstain thing for hints, class, clues. But we will, or I will hunt someone down. On one other note, though, when I put the dig emote in the emote bar, it is virtually impossible to see the shovel in the emote icon. Can the shovel be made more prominent so we can easily see that this icon represents dig? And neither one of those look very clear to me.
Yeah. I don't see much of a difference from what I can see in either one. Well,
I mean, there's a little like shovel head in the bottom one. It's a little bit clearer, but still, make it a big ass shovel. And then Sanyo, I found a bug with the outhouse spot. If you dig up the chest once, you can't dig it up again. Maybe you dug it up and didn't realize it and are now blocked. At any rate, I fixed the bug I described. So hopefully that also fixes your issue too. The fix is that you can dig up the chest an unlimited number of times until you turn in the trinket to Selic.
Interesting.
Belladonna, I've gone back several times, so until there is a patch on QI, I can't get past it. So I've just been doing the other maps that I can figure out. Still trying to figure out the bloodstained ones. Morkin, to use the lemon, you need alchemy skill. I had skill one and get crazy with the lemon. Maybe a little clue with a treasure hunter would be nice. All in all, treasure hunting is big fun, and I hope we will soon be on the live server soon. Selic does mention in his conversation, if you mention pieces of a map to him about using the alchemy station, so that is one hint on it. There's a couple of issues with Selic's conversations. Ask me, but I won't answer, with a link to something. Here's a bug report. Selic says he'll answer questions about lemons, but does not.
Huh?
Well, if you look at it, the lemons one is not underlined.
I'm at Rinaldi. I don't know what you're... Ask me, but I won't answer.
Did you click the number one, ask me?
Oh, no, I didn't realize that was an actual link. I see what you're saying.
Yes.
I didn't realize that was an actual link to something. I got you.
Yes. And that on QA 1564, this is fixed for both Selic and the Treasure Hunter kids. Da, da, da. And it'll verify on the next public release.
Gotcha.
Then Fu Yu typo. The phrase Fu Yu should be Fool You, although Fu Yu is rather funny. Don't let their young age Fu Yu. Fu Yu. Fu Yu. Fu Yu. Going back to Rinaldi's, the treasure map window has some odd priority issues. If you click the treasure map, the map comes to the front and displays on top of other windows, but the control button's in the upper right-hand corner of the treasure map. X to shut the map, the circling arrows always behave as if they are behind other windows. In order to close the map or look at the other one, you must drag the map window to a place where the X and circling arrows are not overlaying any other windows, then you can click them. And then, are the messages on Bloodstained maps supposed to be revealed in the same way that the messages are revealed on the Decrepit maps? If so, it does not seem to work. If not, then hopefully a hint or recipe somewhere. And Devil Cult's like, yeah, that's my bad. I forgot to add the recipe for the PvP map. They are now in, should be in the next patch. I'll check out for the X button. I remember seeing this behavior. Okay. In the time before reset message and the timed event message supposed to be movable, right now they are movable. I accidentally moved them behind another window and thought they had disappeared. Note, they are movable regardless of whether lock status movement is selected or unselected. Also, I have some suggestions for the reveal hidden message recipe. Changing the naming scheme for these recipes to reveal hidden messages on a map. This title allows the user to search for the recipe by filtering for the word map. which is a likely term that will be used to search for those recipes. Change the category of the recipes to alchemy miscellaneous. Currently, these reveal hidden recipes are classified as alchemy unclassified. There is no unclassified category listed in the recipe book, table of contents, nor on the crafting table drop-down menu. So it makes more sense to categorize them as miscellaneous because the miscellaneous category already exists and can be selected from the drop-down category. With screenshots.
Yes, helpful screenshots. So yes, Rinaldi, very good.
Yes. It's supposed to be movable anytime. I'll check the classification. I didn't want it to be in there at all since the same recipe for everything, and it ended up being one of each of them. Need to check what I can do with this. Belladonna, not right now, but soonish. It would be nice to take the dug up maps and be able to frame them, or at least have them somehow to be used as deco. Framed would be cool since we can use the same things we need for the other framed maps, but some way to incorporate them into deco once it's been dug up. Before digging up and dug up maps should both be deco. Deco for both of them.
What do you mean? An unused map and a used map both as deco?
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about that. Yeah. You know, why waste a map?
You know what? I mean, at some point in time, you're going to be like, someone's going to be like, I want this as deco. I don't want to go dig it up. I want it to be like Goonies.
I'm going to guess, or as we hate to say, assume that the, you know, already dug up map is going to represent the same exact unused map. So why bother? Why just, you know, use a waste of treasure? You know what I'm saying?
Hey man, are the rewards worth it? I mean, you'll find out that the deco people are going to be wanting more deco anyways.
Well, again, if it's the same map, I mean, if the map looks differently after it's been used, that's one thing. But if it looks exactly the same, I just say after it's been used, then it can be made into deco. That's just my thoughts.
My thoughts are both.
And Tina says no one would be forcing you to.
Yeah.
Can we sanitize the book in general? What are you talking about? The recipe book?
Sanitize the recipe books? I mean, make them more functional?
Yeah, you know, like, like actually alphabetize them instead of them just going, these recipes going in however the hell you put them in into the next slot type thing? Or the recipe is just going into a preset slot like they did in UO so that every book looked exactly the same? You mean that kind of sanitize? Because that would be nice.
Something. Yeah. And Belladonna reporting, well, since the last patch, I went back to Selic and that got that quest completed. Yay.
Yay.
I then proceeded to do the maps that I had again. Only problem I have on the Bloodstain map is that I got the message the map was removed from inventory, fought the wave battle, and went back in to finish digging. I got the event timer thing, but could no longer dig for the chest to get it to pop up. Not sure if it was me or that is the chance you take of taking too long to get back to it. Constantly had the timer going. This one is in Libris, so it might be buggy. Who knows? Never could get the chest to spawn. On another note, although if you have multiple maps and go dig them up, the loot is not random. Not sure if this is supposed to be that way or not. Some cool loot so far.
Okay. Well, that's promising. Yeah, the Belladonna thinks it's cool loot.
Yeah. And then, what do you mean the loot is not random? It should be random everything. I haven't added loot yet to the PvP chest, which could be why you are seeing the same kind of stuff. But also, did you get the first bug in other maps or just Libris? I'll check that one out. And then Devil Cult, I thought about making the maps deco, but we would end up with just too many. It wouldn't be good for performance and it would break current treasure map behaviors and complicate things a lot code-wise. Overall, was not worth it, but we never know if we find some light way to do it.
So he thinks it would take up too much space. So? Do you think everybody and their dog is going to map, frame all of them? And what difference does that make between that and any other deco item out there? If people have paintings all over the place, it's the same difference. It just takes up a fucking deco slot. I don't see how that could be, but breaking.
I don't know.
Yeah. See, now this is the conundrum as I was talking about just a minute ago. It wouldn't be good for performance. Break current treasure map behaviors and complement.
I don't see how.
Is especially if you're making something else out of it. If you take a treasure map and use it as part of a recipe, and it changes into a frame version, which is a totally different item type.
But then if you go back and salvage it, you just return the treasure map.
You would think,
as Tina says, shroud math.
Shroud math.
I mean, it might be because the salvage system is a lot of RNG that would have to be removed.
The salvage system could be used, but you don't have to use, you take that. Again, I don't understand half of their conundrums, let's take the vendor zone listing, as it is, and people want a vendor cell listing. I don't see why you just can't take that script, copy it, change the variables, and drop it in. I mean, I don't see what makes that so hard, but Devil Cult says it's very hard to do. You take the existing script that calls for the, sell listing, and you just call the buy listing. I mean, I don't see how that is hard, but I'm gonna
just give it a damn mesh. I mean, it's like art time.
Yeah, but again, the way we see things, I'm going to jump up to our last topic in there today. Revisiting Bergen's more visible mouse cursor thread, because apparently, he's going to try and push this. But again, let's read the first one first again, just to refresh everybody.
How about an option to make the mouse cursor more visible? Like how the cursor turns green when hovering over something interactable. But maybe magenta, like the missing texture color. A bright magenta cursor would be much harder to lose. I constantly lose the mouse pointer in certain scenes. Mouse trails are not a thing on Linux, and a large mouse option bypasses the hardware cursor and really sucks, especially in heavily populated towns. Hate my cursor.
That was September 11th, and then on Saturday.
I really hate losing my cursor. This could be such a simple fix.
How simple is it?
It would be an option for high-vis cursor, which removes the texture, and then it becomes the pink one. Because remember, if you look back at the game, the mouse cursor itself, I mean, if it was just pink, it would be.
Well,
then they would have to figure out like.
As I move my cursor, it's white normally. When you hover over something like you can use, it turns green. If you hover it over like a player's name, it turns yellow.
And blue.
You know, and then blue, you know. So, you know, would the mouse then function if you could just choose the color? You know, would you just change the white to a different color? How easy a fix do you really think this is, Bergen? That's my question.
If they did like a high viz, they removed the texture and it was pink by default, like that, instead of, then they could add like three other colors that are more solid. That would be, instead of being like green, you would you could even do a green, but a solid green for the cursor for the high viz.
Well, explain what you mean by high viz.
So the issue he's having is he's constantly losing his cursor.
The issue he's having is he's in battle scenes where there's a lot of shit going on and the cursor gets lost in that scene. I understand that, okay, because it happens to me from time to time. But I mean, if you just run your cursor around, you'll see where it is at one point, and then you can just hone in on it. But if you're in a battle scene, more likely than not, I don't know about you or me. Yep, what the fuck? Oh yeah, that's nice. It's like an AFK. I don't know how I'm AFK when I'm moving my mouse cursor around on the fucking screen, clicking things and pointing at things. I don't know how I'm fucking AFK. And
hey, man, shroud math.
Yeah. I mean, this shit's just got to stop. This is ridiculous. I mean, I was just about to click on something to show people, and yeah, let's just fucking reboot the scene because, you know, stupid AFK fucking timer, which makes absolutely no fucking sense, sitting in town.
It got shroud mathed.
All right. So anyway, is back to my point. You know, if you're in a battle scene, and I got to drag this up here, I would guess that 90% of the time, you're going to be focused on, you know, your glyphs more than anything else, and you're already going to have a target. Most of the time, I use tab targeting. I don't know about you, so I don't have to take my mouse and go click something. So my mouse should be right here 99.9% of the time in a scene when you're doing something, whether, you know, and, you know, if you're losing your mouse while you're harvesting or shit like that, well, then you really have a problem.
Yep.
Yeah. Moving your mouse should, you know, especially when I'm pointing at a million different things, but again, anyway, so I don't know how you're losing your mouse when you should be, you know, sitting here clicking on shit down here while you're fighting. And most of your targeting should be done, again, like I said, is, you know, I use tab targeting. I don't know about the rest of y'all. And occasionally, you know, I'll do a double click, but, you know.
Yes.
But, yeah, if you think it's an easy fix, well, let's see how easy it is. Let's see if the devs even address this, because it's been a month now, and, yeah, not a single comment from the devs on this topic. But I just thought it funny that Bergen brings it back up and goes, well, this should be easy. Fix my problem. You know what? First off, you're the only person complaining about it.
Well, he's also not using Windows, so.
Yeah, you're also using, you know, you're one of five people using Linux out there. But you know what? We blew past the butt of the hour, so let's stop what we're doing.
And pull one of three person.
And give Lomir Selenia.
Selenia.
And it is Lomir. That's funny. I was joking. But Selenia,
give me a streamer bundle.
Selenia Soda. What's going on?
Yeah. Yes. Long time no see. But remember, give the dev team kudos for getting things on the QA server several weeks before something goes to production for testing.
Yes. Again. Now, of course. That wasn't the only thing. On Friday, we actually covered
Easel thingy.
Easel. That was out there. Thank you. You're welcome, Omer.
Yeah. And for this is also for people providing feedback. You should provide screenshots and video of every single issue that you're reporting. And if you have a problem with that, remember posting, you can put a picture in Discord and then submit the link to that image to embed it. It's not hard.
Not hard at all, but let's see. Do you want to talk about some scrap? Or how about some craftable items? I don't know. I'll let you figure it out.
Let us talk about hold on. I'm closing tabs. Let's talk about moat.
Moat. Okay. You want to go with moat. Okay.
Yes. Moat house. Scene/area, the moat house, which is a wishlist request. With giant frogs being in the game, consider placing a ruined moat house in the game. This scene area is a total Easter egg, paying homage in part of two pen and paper Dungeons and Dragons from way back. It was part two of the module, The Village of Homlet, and in T2 in the module, The Temple of Elemental Evil. Wasn't The Temple of Elemental Evil also referenced in, what's that book that became a movie? And the movie kind of sucked because it wasn't the 80s homage, but it became everything. They included like Overwatch characters for today's kids.
I have no idea.
Ready Player One.
Oh, Ready Player One? Yes. What happened there?
Yes. I believe they referenced the Temple of Elemental Evil in the book for finding the first Easter egg. Two brown or pale Goliath frogs are the two giant frogs outside the moat house in the swamp. The moat house is occupied by bandits and swamp critters, maybe some ebon cultists. The dungeon underneath it contains spiders and scorpions in some parts, undead in others, but mainly ebon cultists. A boss or mini boss cultist is the heavy hitter in the dungeon. If the moat house can fill in the storyline, great. Otherwise, place it in some swampy scene, cough, cough, mysterious swamp. Yes. Choosing beggars. Yes. the moat house is huge compared to the huts found in the swamps we currently have. Dun, dun, dun. Here's a link to Drive-Thru RPG with.
Yeah, I checked the link earlier, but I mean, I assumed there would be like a picture of what he was referencing. No. So but there's no picture. So, I mean,
you'd have to download the PDF and then you'd have to download the PDF and then go through the
entire PDF. I mean, this there.
You'd have to buy it.
Oh, $4.99. I got you.
Yeah.
I gotcha.
But yes,
And Tina says, ultimately, you can't complain too much, Jack. The people who are submitting info are volunteers. Hey. You mean like the staff?
Yes.
You mean like the staff, right? Okay. Just want to check and make sure that we reiterate that, because, you know, the inmates are running the asylum these days, right? Let's just make sure that we understand that very well.
Yeah. Like, think of all of the feedback. David is paid, but is he full time? And yes, qualify that as far as you know.
Yeah.
Because
he paid in real cash? Is he paid in kodos? Is he paid in, you know, deeds? How is he paid?
Yeah.
Yeah. We don't know is the actual, yeah.
Yeah, we don't know how many full-time devs are on the project.
Because they won't tell us who's actually on the payroll anymore. They won't tell us, yeah. Yeah, well, again, you know, is I know David puts in like a 70, 80-hour week into this. He puts in a lot of fucking time into this game, and I'm hoping he's paid very well for it. But my understanding is that David puts in more hours than he should into this game, and I got to commend him for that, because, again, it's one of those things that when you have a passion for something, you will definitely go above and beyond just because you want to see things work and be functional. But, you know, is the salary, you know,
commiserate with experience?
Yes, that's exactly what I was trying to get out. Thank you. Commiserate with, yeah. 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 But again, you know, is Ravlox getting paid? You know, the only one I know is probably that we know is getting paid is Sanyo. Yeah, you know, is
yeah.
Well, yes, nobody on the Bug Brigade is staff. We understand that.
Yes, everybody's a volunteer.
Unless you want to count Justin, unless you want to count Alley-Oop, who are staff, but again, I believe they're also volunteer staff, so. Yeah, so you got to take that with a grain of salt too. Now, I do know certain things that I just can't divulge on, you know, some of this stuff, but that's my purview, and I'm just gonna stick to my guns. You know, I can't give away stuff that I've promised not to talk about. I can't divulge my sources on where this information comes from, but yeah.
Yep.
So they'll get what they get, and they'll like it, yes.
You will suck it, tamers.
Suck it, miners. Suck it, players. Yes. Yeah, you know, we're, you know, again, 10 months in, no Chris. You know, not a single peep in game. Not a single peep out of the game. Well, a lot of peeps out of the game, nothing.
Hold on. Do you have Chris on your friends list?
On which friends list? I got him on multiple friends lists.
Well, he last logged into the game on 5/28.
Oh, did he? Atos?
Yes. Yes. Lord British logged in for his birthday party, of which Chris couldn't show up to that in-game event due to scheduling conflicts.
Yeah.
His job is before, taking precedence.
Before that, it was in January, so, I mean, he must have slipped in one day. He
hasn't logged into the forums, I don't think, still since January. Since
January, yeah.
And then we can check that real quick by looking up Chris. And then see whether or not, when is the last time that Chris logged in, last seen January 14th, 2023, in the forums. Yes, gotta say, Chris who? It's like, where is the guy that owns the game? supposedly.
Yes. Yeah, we're not going to go there.
Yeah, King Ghoster.
All right, moving right along.
Moving right along. We are moving to
Treasure Maps.
No, we already covered Treasure Maps.
And not this Treasure Maps.
craftable. Let's talk about some crafting. Hi there. After testing the treasure maps on QA, I got the idea that it would be great if we could organize events by player with maps to realize a scavenger hunt. So you'd use a screenshot of the lot in a town. The screenshot could be printed on a map. Then you can mark a point on the map and write some words on the backside. For the event, all players who take part who get a first map and have to find the lot on the map, and they found the lot, they have to search for a chest or a small bag. This chest or bag contains the next map to the next lot. After several maps, the organizer or other person checks the sequence. The player reaches the final place to determine the winners. A dream would be if we can place a treasure chest on our lots. That would be much more serious, but I'm afraid that would be too difficult to realize. That Sean guy with yes.
Yeah, now, you know, again, the tech is in to do a treasure map, and I don't understand why it would have to be a lot, first off. Why would it have to be a lot?
Yeah.
You know, you could go, you know, I'm thinking, let's just say, exact opposite of treasure. I'm just going to step out of the lot for a second. But, you know, the exact opposite of digging up a treasure chest, say you took your shovel and you stepped to an area in your town and you went here and then you used your shovel to dig a hole and place a chest. And once you place the chest, it would create a map that appeared in your backpack that you can then hide someplace. Or throw into the loot table by selling it to your vendor, you know, like the trash for treasure, and and who's this Armith Shadowstring? What's up, Armith?
Yes.
Yeah,
that
and then
would be. It's not a complicated process there.
Yeah, that would be nice. Or. You know, you could take a public cash chest like this and say you dug, you know, 20 chests in a place. You put them in the cash chest and then people would, you know, get to take one map apiece. And of course you would have an item in only one of, you know, or, you know, first, second, third of the chest that you bury. And, you know, the person who comes up with, you know, the prize wins said prize, you know. You know, it could be, you know, listen, the, you know, I'm just going to use teleport scrolls. You know, I'm going to use teleport, zone, and recall scrolls. Okay, I'm going to bury those. And the person who comes up with the bundle of 20 is the person who wins, you know. Meanwhile, the other bundles will be fives and tens or ones, you know what I'm saying? And at that point,
Matthias 123484 just followed. Thanks for joining us, Matthias 123484.
Matthias 123484. Interesting. Are you a spammer or are you actually a follower?
No, the spam message is you can join all your friends in a few minutes.
Ultima Online or Shroud of the Avatar? Shroud of the Avatar.
Ultima Online. We're covering Shroud, though.
Yes.
We discussed Shroud.
We've been around since Ultima Online, let's put it that way. But yes, this is Shroud of the Avatar. If my shirt wasn't enough for you to say Shroud of the Avatar, if we weren't sitting in the game Shroud of the Avatar, because this doesn't look like Ultima Online by any means,
But
yes.
things Shroud of the Avatar is not. UO2.
The spiritual successor.
Barely.
Successor.
Yes. Here are issues galore. So Shroud is really what you make out of it. It is
absolutely
there is a lot of things in Shroud that are done and can be done. It's just one where we wish that many of these systems were not
done better,
half implemented. Yeah, and we wish that there was more polish provided to
like the old cooking skill, which has one skill for cooking compared to all the other trees that have multiples. You know, we'd like to see cooking fleshed out finally, you know.
or the fact that, like, go to Subterfuge and you've got like a pickpocket skill that only works in PvP. You can't pick pockets of NPCs. Lockpicking.
And you have to be a PvPer to pickpocket. You can't just pickpocket normally, which is stupid.
Remember, lockpicking was there for a bit, and that was taken out.
They took that out, yeah.
Yeah. And so it's like...
You know, lockpicking...
It is one where it's like...
would go really great with the new treasure hunting, because if you had a high level chest that needed to be lockpicked on top of the fact that you need to dig it up, well, how many times do you think that people are burying buried treasure but not putting a fucking lock on it? We're just going to leave the chest open and we're going to bury it that way, so anybody who happens to come across it can just open the lid and take out our treasure. No, usually it's locked.
And Knight Rider has a question about pickpocketing. Does it work in PvP? I think they actually took that out, so you can't pickpocket other people anymore. Because someone went AFK in a PvP zone and had all their shit taken from them, and they complained.
No, that's why they put the fucking AFK timer in. Yeah, that was again stupid. Yeah, listen, you got to understand that the idea of PvP in a game means you're going to lose your shit, period. If you're going to PvP, anything you carry is fair fucking game. End of story. I don't want to hear, I didn't know I could lose my stuff. And again, there are exceptions, like newbie items, like items you buy from the store. There are ways to protect your stuff. But, I think the character should still be able to carry gold, and if you got yanked, while you were carrying 200,000 gold, that gold goes to the fucking victor, man. To the victor, go to spoils.
Damn Skippy. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So
absolutely, like old days in UO. Yeah.
Over the course of PvP loot testing, they have gone with a few random items. They have gone with no loot, but they've never actually tested a full loot
system, which we've been asking them to do since the invention of PvP here. Is we've told them, if you want to gain people to come into this game, I guarantee you, if you go full loot, you'll get a whole bunch of people showing up to play this fucking game. Yeah. But when there's no risk, no reward, and they always talk about risk and reward. Well,
and the fun thing there is, then from there, it is one where it's like, anytime you die in a scene, you should drop everything looted from that scene, which is something else. So
that gets a little bit more technical, but yes, I always liked but disliked the original UO. When you die, whatever you had on you was dropped.
Yeah.
Unless there was some kind of protected on. Yeah.
That's where I said only items.
Items like, looted in that scene. Yeah. In that scene. Now, if you change scenes, does that reset your flag? Is that your contention?
Yes.
So
yes.
If I go out and I mine 1,000 ore in one scene, and I go to a wooded scene and I start chopping wood, the ore that I looted in the previous scene is now safe and no longer susceptible to being looted. Yes. See, I think that, again, like anything else, you know, anything you're carrying that's not newbied, and there was a way to newbie things also after a while.
Did the Guild Wars feature ever get tested?
Yeah.
Yeah, but this goes back to the Shroud of the Half-Assed. Because
if I go into Guild War. Yeah, hold on. See, if I go into the Guild and I declare war on another guild member,
everybody in the guild as
everybody PvP. Becomes, yes, everybody becomes a PvPer, whether they like it or not.
Yeah. And it's like, this is Shroud of the Half-Ass. We don't have the like alliance system. We don't have realistic guild war system. We don't have a faction system to where it's like, you could have like, as we've talked with Richard about, four different factions. And then those alliances between those four factions can be very ambiguous. Yeah, it's not just the guild that's being targeted. You become PvP for everyone. It's Shroud of the Half-Assed.
Yeah, that too. So the minute you flag as PvP at war for another guild, everybody in your guild becomes PvP, and that makes you a target for everybody, not just at war with the other guild, which, again, not quite absolutely implemented moronic. Properly. And then there's the bug that if... Hey, I flag PvP and I start a party.
Everybody that joins that party becomes PvP flagged.
But they become invincible because they can't be killed. Remember that bug?
Yeah.
Is that still a thing? They get flagged PvP, but you can't PvP them?
Got fixed at some point in time, but it's silly.
Yeah. So again, full loot. You know, and again, you can take it like this. Any items that you have locked, if you lock an item into your inventory, which I have shit tons of locked items, your locked items are not lootable. So you have to be super diligent when you're out there farming.
You would also have to limit the number of items that could be locked.
Well, see, that therein lies a problem because, again, I'm carrying thousands of items on me, literally. I mean,
Well, I'm aware of that. I'm aware.
Yeah.
Hey, they also need to work on the system of gear breakage, to actually make the economy healthier for crafters.
Well, first you need to take away the fact that everybody can craft their own shit, but that's another whole story.
Well, yeah, I mean...
But that's a story for tomorrow.
So because, many conversations.
PvP plus FFA, yes.
Shroud of the Half-Ass. But Laz, you know what time it is?
I do. That's what I just said.
It's time for me to give that single person who entered the streamer bundle, Knight Rider... The only person that was in it.
Yeah. And I have only one person in mine as well. And that was Stringfellow Hook.
Oh, yeah. It's a streamer bundle in Knight Rider's mailbox.
Either that or it just got hung up and didn't show everybody.
You know what? But Jigoku getting a new Steam key from me for following Jigoku today and watching. She is going to be getting a copy of Professor Lupo Ocean. Boom. That's right, Jigoku. Boom.
Bring fellow hawk. There you go. As I click on you, send you your streamer bundle. If my bundles will open properly.
Let's go see what Professor Lupo is going to cost. If it would actually do right.
There you go, string fellow.
Ocean. That one's a cheap one.
Gonna pull the last giveaway of the day. And that winner is gonna be Tina O'Neill. Tina, hopefully you don't have a copy of what I'm about to pick out of the bundle for you. So let's see what we've got for Tina out of the Mystery Game Key bags. And Tina, you have a copy of Pure Farming 2018. Dorito bribes work.
Doritos. Yes. But thank you guys for watching. It is time for Liza and myself to head out.
That's right. We'll be back with more tomorrow right here on NBNN. Until then, I'm Laz.
I'm Jack.
And we are NBNN. Have a great day, everybody. We'll see you all tomorrow.
Bye-bye.